Unitarian Universalist Congregation of the Hudson Valley.
Good morning, everybody. So good to see you all. Today's opening words are written by religious educator Jeff Liebman. The Greek philosopher Plato compared the human mind to a ship on which the sailors had mutinied and locked the captain and the navigator in a cabin. On such a ship, the sailors feel free to steer the ship as they like, but their direction is erratic. The goal of our RE programming in our congregation has been to help our youth free their navigator and captain, and to guide them as they have learned to take command of their ship of life. Today, our youth sail their ships out of the safe harbor, but we want them to know that their ship joins a mighty fleet of kindred souls facing the storms together. Today, they steer to ports unknown, but we want them to know that wherever they drop their anchor, fellow travelers are there to greet them, to guide them, and to be their companions, whatever joys or difficulties their journeys may bring.
The chalice will now be lit in the sanctuary. If you have your own chalice, please light it now too, and let us know that you've done so by typing in the chat at the bottom of your screen. This morning's chalice lighting words are by William Ellery Channing. The great end in religious instruction is not to stamp our minds irresistibly upon the young, but to stir up their own, not to make them see with our eyes, but to look inquiringly and steadily with their own, not to give them a definite amount of knowledge, but to inspire a fervent love of truth, not to form an outward regularity, but to touch inward springs. Please join me in saying our unison affirmation, which will be on the screen. Inspired by love, our mission is to seek our true nature, connect deeply and openly, and act for justice.
Good morning again, everyone. Since time immemorial, across religions and cultures, people honor and foster the transition from childhood to adolescence with ritual. Unitarian Universalists call it coming of age. Coming of age runs parallel to the Jewish tradition of bar or bat mitzvah and the Christian tradition of confirmation. Today, four of our middle school youth have prepared pre-recorded video credos that they will be sharing with you. Throughout the coming of age program this year, they were mentored by Monica Dietrich and Shane Dietrich, along with some sessions with Betsy Tomic. Credo is a Latin word that means, I believe this. In our UU faith tradition, we often say that revelation is continuous and revelation is not sealed. Our faith community understands religious exploration to be a project for a lifetime. During this meaning-making lifelong process, we might find that our beliefs may shift, our views might change, and we transform ourselves, and in turn, the world. To our youth who are coming of age today, Emily, Kobe, Jaylin, Luke, what you are sharing with us today is a beautiful gift, and we are so proud of you. And we're proud of the work you've done during the year of questioning and investigating. You remind all of us that ours is a living faith, that we are never complete, that we are never finished. We are always yet to be. And may you always allow others to be and help and enable each other to grow toward all that we are capable of becoming. It's good to remember that your parents are on journeys with you, bravely balancing protection with encouragement. Emily and Matt, Janelle and Kevin, Sonia and Scott, Heather and Matt, you have our support and you have our love. We are very proud of your young people. Before we go on to our hymn, I want to mention that we are doing things a little differently today. We usually ask that the chat stream not be used during much of the service. However, during the youth credo statements, if you are moved to do so, we welcome and encourage written comments in the chat space so they can later be shared with our youth. Now, please join us in singing the hymn, How Could Anyone Ever Tell You?
Now we will have a few words by our coming of age mentors, Monica Dietrich and Shane Dietrich.
Hi everyone. So my name is Shane Dietrich, for those who don't know. This was my first time working with kids, and honestly, I don't know the first thing about it. So I decided to just sort of take this group as just a group of young people, and what a cool young group of people this is. I'm so proud and excited to get to know them. One of my first memories of this group is we had ordered pizza for them, and we told them that they could either use the reusable dishes and wash them in the sink, or we gave them permission to be lazy and use the paper plastic products. And they all decided that they were going to wash up and use the reusable stuff. Monica and I were so impressed. And from that moment forward, these people consistently showed up to display thoughtful, caring, conscientious minds. And I'm very, very excited to present their credos. I think that they are all wonderful. I think that they all gave a lot of thought and effort into it. And it helped me think about what I think and what I feel. I'm very grateful to them for this learning experience that they gave me. And I'm excited to see the people that they become in our community.
I shouldn't have let Shane go first. And my first brush with Unitarian Universalism was in 2014. And I had stumbled into All Souls in Manhattan. And that Sunday, it just happened to be their coming of age service where youth were presenting their credos. And I remember sitting there being so amazed and inspired and a little jealous of all those youth, because I grew up Catholic. So when I started questioning the world and trying to figure out what I believe, which I think is just a developmental rite of passage in adolescence that we should honor, and I love that UUism does that. I didn't have those resources to explore. And so to see those kids stand up and say what they believe, what they don't know, what they do know, what they're still learning, what they think about God or the universe or nature or faith, and how they expected that to change their whole lives, it was like finding a home. And so this opportunity to work within our own community with our wonderful group of youth this year has really solidified that feeling of home in this faith. And it's been a privilege and a joy to work with these kids over the course of the year, these young people. And I wanna thank them for their engagement with us, their participation, for putting up with Shane and I asking them to elaborate on their thoughts and us holding really awkward silences. And I wanna thank their parents for helping them show up and for facilitating this growth and learning. I have loved seeing this development. I think their credos are really impressive. And I think it's wonderful that they know that they're going to still grow and learn, and that we get to see this as adults, as our own challenge for our own spiritual learning and continuing to grow. Logistically, I'm going to turn off the spotlight video controls, and I'm going to encourage you to turn on your gallery view by clicking on the button on the top right-hand corner of your screen, just so that you can see the other members of our community and maybe our youth as they're watching these credos as well. I just think that'll be really special. If you have no idea what I'm talking about though, or how to do that, don't worry about it. You're still gonna see the videos. It's no problem at all. And with a little bit further ado, here we go. In life, there are many questions that keep you up at night. You lay awake trying to answer these questions that seem unanswerable. I believe that I'll always search for these answers, but this is what I think right now. Hello, my name is Emily Clayton. I am 13 years old and in the 8th grade at Sleepy Hollow Middle School. I enjoy going outside, riding my bicycle, and spending time with my friends. When I think about what shaped me, the first thing that comes to mind is my mother. I think her views of life have really molded my beliefs. For instance, my mom tries to live each and every day being kind, and that's something I try to do too. My mom also tries to make the world better, and that's something I care about as well. I think the meaning of our existence is very simple, just to find happiness, love, be kind, and make the world better. That's what makes life meaningful. A lot of people find their meaning in religion, but I think I would consider myself more of a spiritual person. To me, being spiritual means that there is more to this world than the things you can see and touch. Being spiritual can sometimes be a feeling, like when you're having a family dinner or you're outside in a beautiful landscape that makes you feel connected to the universe. I don't really think that people are born inherently evil. I believe people are shaped by their upbringings and experiences, just like I have been. Everyone is born with the potential to be good, but they make choices in response to their circumstances that determine if they are good or evil. For example, I have a baby cousin who was born last August. When I look in her eyes, I don't see anyone with the capacity to be evil. I just see goodness. I think her experiences in life will determine the kind of person she becomes. If anyone would ask me what being a Unitarian Universalist means, I would say that it's about being welcome and inclusive to everybody. In our church, everyone is welcome to share joys and sorrows, sing and pray together, no matter what they believe or where they come from. To me, being UU means not only including people, but also working to make the world a better place so everyone feels welcomed and valued. There are still so many questions that remain unanswered to me. For instance, what happens when you die? I've always wondered this, but I still don't have a clue about what happens when your heart stops bleeding. Life is a never-ending puzzle. I don't think I'll ever find the answers to these questions unless I search for them. If I search hard enough, I just might find the answers, or perhaps even more questions.
Hi, I am Kobe Carter, and I am 12 years old. I go to Pleasantville Middle School. I like to play sports like soccer and baseball and love to collect trading cards. I believe that I don't know exactly where I am yet, because I don't think I will ever know or need more time to figure it out. I have always felt like living life is the best way to live, especially in these times. Living life has helped me to be who I am today because of how you control what happens to the future, so always try to do what you can do the best way. My family and friends have helped me to be who I am today because they really supported me my whole life and kept me going.
Hi, I'm Jalen Green. I'm in sixth grade and go to AMD Middle School. I live in Austin, New York, and live there all my life. I do springboard diving, but since the coronavirus, I started mostly after school work, have been playing on my Xbox One. My favorite games are Minecraft and Roblox. My favorite subjects in school are social studies, ELA, and science. Although I don't consider myself religious, I do somewhat believe in God. That means to me that I believe God is a force. To me, this force is a part of the universe and partnered with Mother Earth. To me, human nature is both good and bad, meaning all people have both good and bad in them. Even people who consider themselves generally good still have bad in them, or they might be good, but still might do bad things. Unitarian Universalists welcome all religions, which I think is a good thing. I am both Jewish and Christian too, which makes me feel special because nobody I know is both Jewish and Christian. The most important social issue to me is the environment. The environment is important because I feel our society abuses our planet and people cause the life to shorten, the planet to shorten. Earth contains all humans despite culture, religion, traditions, and protecting Earth is and its forces of human or of nature is being sacred. Lastly, I'd like to know more about the people that founded the Unitarianism and how the thoughts developed around the idea. I'd like to know more about other religions and how they connect too.
Hi, my name is Luke Widener and I am 13 years old and live in Sleepy Hollow. I believe in friendships, love, and family. What this means is that I take people for who they are and expect that they do the same for me. I do my best to be open-minded and kind to others. I also believe in stories having the power to change minds. They make people think deeply. I believe strongly in human rights. I get angry when I hear people disrespecting and disregarding people as lesser because of their race, gender, sexuality, and other aspects of who they are. When I get angry about these subjects, I do something about it, like help my school join a program which combats hate and discrimination. During quarantine, I've been struggling to stay level-headed. I get frustrated with a lot of my online schoolwork, and I can't see my friends in person. Recently, though, my dad pointed out a quote from Lord of the Rings by Gandalf. The book reads, "I wish it need not have happened in my time," said Frodo. "So do I," said Gandalf, "and so do all who live to see such times. But that is not for them to decide. All we have to decide is what to do with the time that is given us." This quote has helped me a lot, so I hope it helps you too.
Okay, we will be having joys and sorrows now. Oh, what a joy. What a joy to hear our beautiful youth. Let me just set the stage. Give me 1 minute.
Claire.
So we're at a little out of order.
Yes, and I apologize.
I'm going to introduce the piano piece.
Oh, okay.
So, all right. Sorry about that, everybody. You are about to hear Christine Clayton play Scenes from Childhood by Robert Schumann. It's Schumann's most quiet and introspective piece, Scenes from Childhood. How fitting for this day, Christine's daughter, Emily, comes of age. So here's Emily Clayton playing Scenes from Childhood. Thank you.
Now we will have our joys and sorrows. I'm overwhelmed. Beautiful. So we will now bear witness to the joys and sorrows experienced in our community. If you have a personally significant joy or sorrow, please type it in the chat and I'll read it aloud. So I'm seeing some very brief. Someone just wrote beautiful. I apologize. I couldn't see who that was. Al says, lost my niece Nancy to breast cancer. So sorry, Al. From Steph to everyone, I'd like to light a candle in support. And I couldn't read the brass, I apologize.
Claire, would it be helpful for
Claire, if you just scroll up in the chat box, it'll slow it down and you'll be able to read it better.
I'm having trouble seeing the chat box. So
it might be because you're on an iPad. Would it be easier for me or Steph to read?
Do you mind? I think that would be better.
Not at all. Steph, I can take over unless you want to.
Sounds good.
Okay. I'm going to scroll up for a second. Okay. From Shane, it was a joy to have gotten to work with Monica, Jane, Betsy, and our coming of age group. Also, so much love and gratitude to Monica, this is a weird one to read, for making it possible for Josh, my brother, and Shane to bring water to protesters in Union Square yesterday, sending all my energy to people on the streets fighting for their rights and for a better future for us all. Molly says, a dear, very longtime friend of Dawn's and mine, Chuck Hilty, died last night of COVID. Her heart aches. Karen Sue says her mom is having a difficult time. Please keep her in your thoughts. John's ex-wife and daughter are successfully recovering from COVID-19, a relief. Jim and Ginny are having the joy of seeing videos and photos of their granddaughter at the Russell Cottage in Wells, Maine, sixth generation. Susie writes that her sorrow is that her friend Jack is living in Boston and is housebound due to his illness. She misses him and is sad because his usually cheerful personality is so downcast. The McCurries say the latest string of racial abuses has been upsetting and angering beyond words. Steph would like to light a candle in support of everyone protesting across this country. Their anger is righteous and brave, and this country needs to do better. Pat Krugman was glad to be part of the protests in Peekskill yesterday, but sad to have to protest out of outrage. Eddie says his heart bleeds for the death of George Floyd and all of the Black victims before and after Mr. Floyd. Black Lives Matter. Jana is so sorrowful about the murder of George Floyd and the death of so many others. Protesting is necessary. Change is necessary. The violence is very upsetting. Carrie has a joy that Chris and she got to have a beautiful day to hang out in their garden in the beautiful weather and journal and reflect and enjoy an easy Sunday with perfect weather. From Julian, or actually this, I believe this is Lourdes, my friend Pete Rivera is in the ICU. He had a stroke last week. Please keep him and his family in your thoughts and prayers. Over to you, Claire.
Okay. We acknowledge all of the unspoken joys and sorrows held within the sanctuary of our hearts and all those who have yet to find a spiritual home where they can share their joys and sorrows. We will, here's another one from Jim and Ginny. They have the joy of seeing Janet England. And again, I can't read the, I apologize, my screen does not allow me to read all of them. Thank you all. We are going to go into our offertory at this point. Each week we make an offering from the bounty we are blessed to enjoy. We do this in the spirit of love and generosity, aware that we have benefited from those who have gone before, those who in turn gave generously. Our offering goes to support the work of love and justice undertaken by this community. Today's offering will be shared with Feeding Westchester. You can read more about it in the order of service. The offering will now be given and gratefully received. Please know you can make your donation via credit card or PayPal using the links in your order of service. Please remember to give a little extra to compensate for the 3% surcharge, or if you prefer, you can always mail us a check. Please join me in dedication of the offering. May these gifts and the work of our hands and hearts give power to all we stand for as a community of faith.
If we were meeting in person, this is a time during the service that we would present a small gift to each of our youth, acknowledging their passage from childhood to adolescence. Since we can't be together in person, each youth is receiving via snail mail an artisan crafted necklace that has been hand stamped with an original design of our Unitarian Universalist chalice. Emily, Kobe, Jalen, Luke, with this gift of a chalice necklace, we promise you our continuing support and offer you always a home away from home. We will share with you the hopes and labors in making this a better world, and we will continue to grow together and be witnesses to our living faith. And now I'd like to call forth Heather Hewitt, mother of Luke. She represents the parents of our youth.
On behalf of the Coming of Age youth and their parents and guardians, I would like to thank Monica and Shane Dietrich for the generous gifts of their time and guidance over the past 7 months. Monica and Shane guided the youth through multiple sessions of learning and reflection with dedication, positivity, and lots of energy. They approached their teaching with thoughtfulness, preparedness, and enthusiasm. One parent commented that they seemed to have a magic touch with our youth. And as a parent of a middle schooler, I can tell you this is saying quite a bit. One of our youth commented that they were fun to work with, and another said they were the best teachers ever. Once COVID hit, they continued to lead our youth when group discussions had to move online. Despite these challenging circumstances, they continued to support the writing and reflecting process of our youth. They went above and beyond by spending one-on-one time with some of the youth as they were completing their credo statements this past week. As a small token of our thanks, we are giving both Monica and Shane a $25 gift certificate for the In Spirit UU gift and bookshop. On behalf of all the coming of age youth and their parents and guardians, thank you.
You're all too kind. Thank you. And thank you, parents. Thank you, youth. Thank you.
We will now have the chalice extinguishing. Please join me. We extinguish this flame, but not the light of truth, the warmth of community, or the fire of commitment. These we carry in our hearts until we are together again.
Emily, Kobe, Jalen, Luke. We wish for you a storm or two that you may enjoy the calm. We wish for you tranquility in time of trial. We wish you a cool breeze on a warm day and pale white clouds that may better appreciate the blueness of the sky. We wish darkness for you so that you may see the stars. We wish you anticipation of high adventure, and we wish you the courage to avoid battle. We wish you a sense of wonder and poetry and music. We wish you companionship that you may appreciate solitude. We wish you a friend who will understand you. And we wish you understanding so that you may have a friend. We wish you may become all that you want to be and more than you hope to be. We wish you a flower to smell, a hand to touch, a voice to cheer, a heart to gladden. And we wish you someone to love as we love you. And now, join us, please, in our closing hymn, Spirit of Life.
just want to thank everyone involved with this beautiful service. Jane Podell, our mentors, Shane Dietrich and Monica Dietrich. Of course, our coming of age youth, Emily Clayton, Kobe Crowder, Jalen Green and Luke Widener. And everyone that was involved, our tech crew. Please, we will be having a brief coffee hour, it'll be a coffee minutes, 5 to 10, because we will be having a town hall meeting afterwards. So get your coffee and you will be redirected into your groups. Thank you so much. Thank you, everyone.